This is the main event of the evening.
The intensity for this one is something else. Pongsiri, renowned for his incredible hand power, tremendous kicking ability, and a never say quit attitude. He was not going to wave a white flag. You're watching something special. Inside the massive Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. Muay Thai in four-ounce gloves. It doesn't get any better than this. Roundhouse kicks early from Super Lang. He's going straight after Lau Chitra.
Start breaking down the body and go up top.
Now Chopra has reach in the arms. He's got to use it. He's got to keep Super Leg at bay. Inside thigh kick there from the quick champion. Super Leg goes downstairs. Control and center in. Tracks away with the right leg again. That's under nicely done. Now Chopra applies a clean. Super Leg gets a knee off to the ribs. And referee Onari breaks them. What a start here from the three-time world champion, Super Leg. Outside of the kick again.
No.
Hands low, now lifts them. High on the balls of his feet. Cracks away with that roundhouse kick. Step-through knee there from Super Leg. He is pulling out all the weapons, all the eight weapons of Muay Thai. Here in the first round.
Go!
You can see Lau Chitra's having a hard time with the speed. I don't think he's used to starting this fast. Super Leg is not following the Muay Thai rule set. He is going right after him in the first round, not giving him that warm-up round. You can see the speed difference.
Because this is one super series. It's only three rounds. You can't take a filling out process in the first and second. It's all about action. It's all about knockout. And that's what Super Leg's looking for here in the opening stanza.
He is, and that's what, and you can see that Lau Chitra is having a hard time. He can't get into the clinch. He can't utilize those elbows. There it is. Now he's trying to fire the elbows.
A two-time Muay Thai world champion in the white trunks. Finding the get-go very hard in the opening round here against a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Right hand down the tube there from Super Leg, then goes to the bread basket. Planting right hand from Super Leg. Now Chitra ties him up, chunk for the knees, chunk for the elbow. Knee there from Lau Chitra, downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone. Super Leg just all over it. Glances up to his screen as the three-time world champion to see how much time's left in the round.
Interesting clinch game from Super Leg. He's utilizing the outside over underhooks to get this because he's not trying to swim in and get inside control. He's very comfortable staying on the outside and using the defensive strategy so that he can create openings and throw elbows in the knees of his own.
Go!
A tremendous start from Super Leg Ketmulgar. 2012 Sports Authority of Thailand Muay Thai Fighter of the Year, three-time world champion.
Beautiful straight right hand from Super Leg, right through the guard. Caught Lau Chitra, throws it as he just points the shot right at the tip of his forehead. Beautiful opening round for Super Leg.
110 world champion martial artists here at one championship. You see that in here, Super Leg with a kicking arsenal. More kick than a porous line for Super Leg here in the second round. And here come the hands.
Wow, it was like the first round. He actually was going kind of slow because that was 10 unanswered kicks from Lau Chitra by Super Leg.
Like that 11. And there's 12 and there's 13. That right leg is devastating. Here comes the power from Super Leg. Get moving. Front kick to the midsection. Overhand elbow from Lau Chitra. Trying to get on the inside. And now Super Leg ties him up against the ropes. A little slap and a tingle there from Atsushi Onari. And he breaks it. Look at the defense on the way in from Super Leg. Cracks him over the forearms. That one goes down to the waist. That one goes down to the legs. It is all the right leg of Superleg here in the second round. Belly to the body, belly button through the back. Short elbow on the inside there from Lao Chetra.
Chetra needs more of that straight left hand or that right hand. He needs to put that jab out there. Every time Superleg throws a kick, he's got to answer it. He's got to come back.
High kicks again from Superleg, breaking down the forearms of Lao Chetra. Digs the toes into the midsection. Lao needs to use that reach. High kick there from the Cambodian. The three-time Muay Thai champion in the red and blue. Superleg Ketmulgao doing a number here in the second. Snakes the arms around the back of the neck, drills it into the midsection. Lao no chance to get off the elbows. Referee, oh no, it separates them. It is all out action in one super series. This is Muay Thai with four out gloves. This is the most electrifying martial arts stand-up in the world in four out gloves. And it's awesome to see, Mitch.
It is. And then what is awesome is that right kick from Superleg. He's thrown more right kicks than he has punches in this second round. Look at it, he just keeps hammering the body, the legs, the head of Lao Chetra.
That one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. A punch up in the corner. He got put on by Superleg. Tango against the ropes and referee. Oh, now he breaks them. Final seconds of what has been a cracking second stanza for the three-time Muay Thai world champion, Superleg. And again with the right. Body shot there. Behind the balls of his feet, Superleg. Dancing, grooving. Oozing confidence from every pore. And there's going to be a lot of work for Lao Chetra to do in the final round.
Let's count how many kicks he threw in that opening stanza of the second round. He just goes off and repeatedly, like machine gun fire, starts unloading these kicks. He goes to the arms, he goes to the body, he goes to the head, just over and over. We saw this guy hitting pads this week, and he hits pads like he's hitting the body. Look at him just going over and over to the legs, to the arms, to the body, just punishing Lao Chetra from all angles.
Third and final round. It's been one-way traffic, and all the traffic has come via that right leg, the right shin of Superleg Ketmulgao.
And the whole left side of Lao Chetra's body is a completely different shade than the right side of his body.
It looks like it's been sunburned. It's reddened the entire carcass and the legs of Lao Chetra. And Superleg sets the right leg again, boom, to the midsection. Lao Chetra backs him up, tries for a flying knee to no avail. Chuck the elbows off the right here.
Stop.
And referee, oh, now he breaks it.
Man, we're seeing incredible offensive strategy from Superleg. But we're seeing defense as well. We're seeing a very pinpoint, accurate defensive strategy from Superleg. And that's what's made Lao Chetra so frustrated with. He's not able to do anything. We just saw it as he was trying to jump in for that knee. Just a little subtle adjustment from Superleg, and he was able to stop the jump. It's very impressive.
You are seeing the skill, the poise, the speed, and the scintillating power that has made Superleg Ketmulgao a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Racks away again with the right roundhouse kick. That shin has done incredible damage. Knee guard put on here by Superleg. And referee Onari separates both these warriors. Two tremendous athletes, two world champions. Southpaw stance on the Cambodian. His inside leg is a shade of purple, a kaleidoscope for colors. The crowd are counting the kicks from Superman. And they spin to the canvas. Nice dump there from Superman Ketmulgao. Slow to pick himself up. Here's Lao Chetra, 1:05 remaining. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system. And you figure they must have given the first round 10-9, the second round 10-9 to Superleg, the three-time world Muay Thai champion. Superleg winds up the roundhouse kick again, gets out of the way of the elbow. Nice low check there from Superlat. Lines up the right again. Here it comes. There it goes to the body. Doubles up on it. Overhand elbow from Lau Chen. From downward elbow. And he's impressed with the elbow of Kip Mungao.
That's what Lau Chen said he wanted to do. He wanted to close that distance and start dropping those elbows. He's able to do it in the last 30 seconds of the match.
There's a very special lady. We're going to show you her in a moment, who is screaming amongst our super fans here ringside. I'll tell you who she is in a few seconds' time. But she is going bananas for someone in the ring right now. Jumping knee from Lau Chen. Hoping for a Hail Mary shot, hoping for one big salvo to turn the tide, but it's not going to count. It's going to be Superlat victory here in Bangkok.
A unanimous decision from the red corner, Superlat Muaythaigym.
Fadi Khalid and Wang Ding, Tunisia versus China. Fadi brings in the experience and opens up the leg kick early. Front kick from Fadi Khalid. We expect Fadi to use the legs. Wang Din goes heavy on the hands. Cannot afford to take his time to warm up here though. Wang Din needs to get stuck straight into the action. Fadi Khalid trying to control centering. Keep Wang Din on the outside. Fires out the front kick. Wang Din edges forward. Doesn't throw the right hand though. Good use of the push, kicks off the lead leg from Fadi Khalid. Throws a round kick off the right, drifts off counterclockwise. Both men clash shins. Tight guard here on Fadi Khalid is high. Does up for a target though on the rib cage of Khalid should Wang Ding go after with his roundhouse kicks. You have got to wonder though how the big occasion will affect Wang Ding tonight. On the biggest stage of all here at ONE Championship. Again, using those front kicks and push kicks. Thought about a jumping knee and a high left round. Another front kick there from Fadi Khalid. Doing a good job here, Khalid. Goes the inside thigh. May have just clipped the groin cup there of Wang Ding. Khalid brings in a record of 39 and 8. Wang Ding not far off, 30 and 7. They call Khalid the gladiator. And the gladiator continues to come forward on the red trunks of Wang Ding. Wang Ding out of Hewan, China. Only 22 years old. So many great Chinese athletes in ONE Super Series. They really have come on strongly over the last 18 months here. And we are seeing a new breed in Wang Ding. Nice high kick there from Fadi Khalid. Tries to get airborne. Does the Tunisian sticks out that left leg? Low check. Wang Ding has not used the legs nearly enough here. Fadi Khalid has been on the attack constantly since the opening bell. It's been an impressive round. We do have three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system, which means give the winner of the round 10 points. The less dominant athletes gets 9. A flurry there from Fadi Khalid. They lock up. Chance for the knees, chance for the elbows. Allowed under these Muay Thai rules. Muay Thai known as the art of 8 weapons. The hands, the elbows, the knees, and of course, the kicks. Oh, downward elbow from Fadi Khalid. How do you do? Trying to crack the clavicle of Wang Ding. Beautiful work from Fadi Khalid. Didn't take him long to open up the elbow artillery, Fadi Khalid. Now goes down to the sternum. Good jab too there from the Tunisian. And Wang Ding returns the favor. But this is all one-way traffic so far. Another chopping strike there from Fadi Khalid. He has turned on the fireworks in the opening round, Dragon.
Yeah, that first round was all Fadi Khalid. You kind of see as the round progressed, Wang Ding kind of got a little bit gun-shy and was afraid to truly commit.
As we open up round 2 of 3, let's see if Wang Ding can maintain center ring here. Fadi turns around easily, presses him against the ropes, a couple of knees in the clinch. And already a good start from Fadi Khalid. Dukes it out with the hands, does Fadi. Downward elbow again from the Tunisian. We are seeing the full employ of all 8 weapons early on here from Fadi Khalid as he dumps Wang Ding to the canvas. Beautifully executed from Fadi Khalid.
jumping front kick. The front kicks off the lead leg of Khaled have been superb. Cracks down to the lead thigh. Nice turning left. And oh, how taste my feet, says Fadi Khaled. Beautifully done from the Tunisian Dragon.
You can start to see Duong Ding starting to push forward. He's trying to get aggressive. But Fadi Khaled just keeps throwing. He does not stop. And this is what we saw a lot from him in his match against Ruantang. But Ruantang just ultimately outworked him. But you can see, oh, he got caught there. It was a stumble.
Can Wang Jing power back, staring down the barrel of a 10-9 loss in the first round, and again the step-up elbows here from Fadi Khaled. The front kick from the Tunisian goes downstairs looking for that quadricep area, cracks away to the upper right rib cage. Step through elbow there from Wang Jing, crossing elbow from the Chinese athlete. Just couldn't connect though. Those elbows are going to slice and dice and fillet the face server. Fadi Khaled to no avail though. Fadi's experience at the highest stage coming through so far tonight. The volume, the aggression, and as I said earlier, the use of all eight weapons of Muay Thai will certainly be looking good to the judges here in Thailand. Step across, outside leg kick there from Wang Din. High kick from Fadi Khaled. Launches that one, just looking to crack away to the forearms of Wang Din. A lot of the Muay Thai kicks will be aimed at the arms deliberately to break the arms down, cause the opponent to drop their arms, expose the head, expose the neck, and they can come over the top of the kicks for a knockout. That's what Fadi Khaled's been trying to do, break down the forearm. There's another couple of knees in the midsection. Tries to fold one thing in half like origami. Back against the ropes now in the clinch. A chance for the elbows and the knees. Good knee to the midsection there from Khaled. Crossing elbow from Wang Ding and they break off. Moving to the final stages of the second round. It's been a corker of a contest. Khaled goes to the lead thigh, liver, thigh again. Good combination work. This has been a treat to watch from Fadi Khaled. The Tunisian all over 22-year-old Wang Ding. Fadi Khaled looking for career victory number 40. 4 centimeter height advantage for Wang Ding really hasn't come into play. And Mitch, I've got to say, another very impressive round for the volume, the aggression, and the array of weapons of Fadi Khaled. I feel here that's going to be a strength for Wang Ding. He needs to get aggressive and maybe a little reckless. He's going to start throwing at angles that Fadi Khaled can't predict here. It's time to pull out all the stops of Wang Ding because he is losing 2 rounds to Nil Dragon.
Yeah, he might have been pacing himself. He might have been kind of saving things up until this final round, but that was a beautiful front kick to the face that Khaled landed. But he keeps coming forward. He keeps trying, but he's not firing anything. He's just standing there. Now he's starting to go. But see that beautiful little sidestep from Khaled? He just knows what's coming at him.
Some better signs here for Wang Ding. Looping shot to the body. Finally, Khaled saw that one coming. Khaled goes inside lead thigh to that femoral profunda. Jabs here from Wang Ding, no right hand for company. Oh, stinging punch to the jaw there from Fadi Khaled, and again loads up that right hand. There is no margin for error in these 4-ounce gloves. They are unforgiving, and Fadi Khaled is using them a treat here in the third and final round. The Tunisian, a house on fire. Ties up Wang Ding now. They tango back against the ropes. A chance for the knees. But referee Kaplun breaks them. Wang Ding comes forward. Oh, in the corner there. Fadi Khaled. Just a slip. Wang Ding needs to up the aggressor meter. Time is against the young man from China. Beautiful step across leg kick. Jumping knee from Fadi Khaled. Pulling out all the stops is Fadi Khaled. Is Wang Ding a little overawed by being on the biggest martial arts stage on the planet? Long reach on the right hand there from Fadi Khaled. Rocks the head back. And Wang Ding does a quick count of his teeth. Looks for the uppercut. But not committing here, Wang Ding. Khaled sets himself. The way that he tucks the chin, looks through the brow. It's just excellent in execution all round, offensively and defensively for Fadi Khaled. Final stages of this bout. It'll take a minor miracle now for Wang Ding to try and peg it back. The front kicks have been superb. So too the outside leg kicks from Fadi Khaled. He's been working combinations, packed with power all night, Fadi Khaled. And he may be seconds away from claiming victory number 40 in his career. The WMC Intercontinental Champion against the top prospect from the One Hero Series. But it's been a dominating performance from Fadi Khaled. He gave up weight, he gave up height. He had experience, and that has shot through tonight. Fadi Khaled will take this one on the judges' scorecards. Mitch, he was all over Wang Ding.
Yeah, Fadi Khaled just put on a masterclass. He was extremely aggressive, but he was also very accurate. Wang Ding did have his moments, but just instances like that where Wang Ding goes to the body, his hands are down, so Khaled goes beautifully up top with the elbow.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner from the blue corner, Fadi Khaled.
Pampayak has beaten Superlek four times, lost once and drew once. Pampayak, 8-2 in his last 10, including wins over Rui Botello, over Superlek Kemulgao and Davison Bashao. Good outside leg kick there from Superlek Kemulgao. Pampayak in southpaw stance, Superlek in orthodox stance. Superlek known as the kicking machine. Lumpini Stadium champion in two weight divisions, Superlek, 118 and 114 pounds. WBC world champion at super featherweight, Superlek Kemulgao. Both men just seeing what each other has to offer in the opening round. Pampayak Jomongnon in the black trunks. A Muay Femur stylist, meaning he's a technical athlete who uses his range exceptionally well. The equivalent in boxing would be a Floyd Mayweather. In fact, Mayweather was an inspiration for Pampayak when he was younger. Solid start here from Superlek Kemulgao. Jab outside leg kick from Superlek. Comes over with the hands now. Roundhouse kick, then body shot from Superlek. Pampayak ties him up in the corner. Superlek scores with a knee off to the left. Online voting polls on the One Championship Twitter feed have 30% of fans saying Superlek will win tonight. 46% are sitting on the fence undecided. Pampayak does have the upper hand. As I said, he's beaten Superlek four times, lost once, drawn once. Good roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Pampayak. Superlek trying to press him against the ropes here. Controlling center in, hook to a round kick there from Superlek Kemulgao. 45 seconds remains in what's been a gripping first round so far, Dragon.
Yeah, these guys know each other so well, they can almost calculate exactly what's going to happen in this match. Pampayak's trying to use the kicks to keep Superlek away while Superlek is trying to close that distance and let those hands go.
25 seconds on the clock now. Superlek has gone 7-3-1 in his last 10, including 2-0 in one Super Series. Has beaten some great names. Sang Mani, Jonathan Haggerty, Christopher Shaw, Wong Tai, Saksan Okwangwang. The list goes on for the great Superlek Kemulgao. Nice step through knee off the right leg there. Let us know, folks around the world, how you scored the first round in this seventh match. Good outside leg kick to open up there from Superlek. Throws the hands, goes high off the right leg, Superlek. Inside leg kick, Superlek, hunting that femoral artery. Tip kick to the lead leg there from Pampayak Jitwangnon. Left hook round kick combination there from Superleg. 121 wins in 151 outings for a huge 80% finishing rate for Superleg Kepmulkar. Very technical style as you're seeing. Powerful knees for Superleg. Big soccer fan, football fan in his spare time. Supports Buriram United FC locally and Chelsea in the English Premier League. Long reach on the left hand there from Pompeyak and a gut-munching knee clinched up in the corner. And referee Klaukan breaks them. We said the big winning rate of Superleg at 80%. Well, Pompeyak has that beaten. An enormous 84% winning rate. Extraordinary high winning rate in the sport of Muay Thai for Pongsiri PK.Saenchai, the 24-year-old. 230 wins, 34 knockouts. Pongsiri, originally from Samut Prakam, about 30 kilometers outside of Bangkok, takes the round kick and gives one back off his left leg, being the rear leg in southpaw stance. They clinch, center of the ring, jockeying for arm positioning. Referee Klaukan allows them to grapple for a moment. Decided there wasn't enough action and breaks them. 1:05 remaining, second round of three dragon.
Lots of forward pressure coming off from Superleg. You can see him trying to land those kicks, trying to open up that left side of the body of Pongsiri. Maybe get him to start covering up with the elbows to that body shot so he can start letting go of the hands up top of the head. But so far, very close matchup. These guys have so much history and they know each other so well. It's just these minor little details who can really get things going in these three-round Super Series matchups.
Nice little knee on the inside there from Superleg Kepmulkar. Half a minute remaining, second of three. Very close contest here. Round kicks off the right leg from Superleg, off the left leg from Pongsiri. Two-time Lumpini Stadium champion at 118 and 126 pounds, Pongsiri. Two-time Rajdhamun champion at 108 and 105 pounds. Beat the great Sam A. Yangadao for the Lumpini Featherweight title, I remember, back in 2015. In the same year, he knocked out Sam A. with a high left kick in just 80 seconds at Rajdhamun Stadium. As we go to the towers at the end of Two Dragon. There's a hit kick early from Superleg to open the third and final. Lines it up again off the right leg. Lowers the boom a little on that occasion. Thought about the jab in Pongsiri and again Superleg. That's why they call him the kicking machine. If he starts to set the metronome with that right leg, he will be hard to stop, Superleg. Pongsiri goes downstairs. A little higher there. Nice wall built by Superleg on the defense. Comes forward, gets into the clinch, backs up Pongsiri now. Chance for the knees, knee bar put on by Superleg and referee Klaukan that breaks them. Round kick from Pongsiri, the 24-year-old. Three-time Sports Writers of Thailand Athlete of the Year. 2013, 2014, 2015 for Pongsiri. That's like winning the MVP in the NBA or winning the Ballon d'Or in soccer. He won it three times in a row, Pongsiri PK.Saenchai. Nice defense against the round kick there. 1:40 remaining. Is it still anyone's for the taking here, Dragon? How do you see it as we're into the final 90 seconds?
Man, this is pretty close. You can just see how well these guys kind of nullify each other's games. This is like their 38th round that they've competed against each other. I haven't had like sparring partners that I've had that much time against. They know each other so well. And you can see that from these shots. Every time they throw, they're deflecting it. They're just these little tiny scores that might happen. And it might be happening inside the clinch, because that's what we've seen a lot in their past matchups, is we've seen Pongsiri score successfully inside that clinch because he's got that length on Superleg.
You know what's really scary, Mitch, is that inside this audience-free arena where you can hear a pin drop, we are hearing the mighty thumping power of these Muay Thai techniques from two of the finest to ever do it, Pongsiri and Superleg. The careening of the round kicks into the legs, into the body. I mean, it sends a shiver down your spine. Can you imagine the sounds we'll be hearing, folks, later on in the night when Jodson Klai starts to wind up his round kicks, when Rod Tung starts to attack the body in 4 ounce gloves. Frightening sounds from an amazing sport brought to you by One Super Series. 15 seconds on the clock here. Looking for a combination as Superlick went high with the kick. We are going to go down to the judges yet again in this heated rivalry that's been going on for so long. Match number 7. Some great action, Mitch, in the clinch.
Yeah, that's where, I mean, in the first round, we start to see these guys kind of in that kicking and punching range. But as the match wore on, they both kind of fell into that kick, that clinch, where they just got nice and tight. Beautifully, you can see a little bit of a stumble there from Pompeyak. Didn't really score, but just constant back and forth action. Ever so close. I think it's going to, you know, come down to that third and final round exactly who did more work inside that clinch and was just more active.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner from the blue corner, Superleg Mugao.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.